Journey with Judy. Honest, open, transparent. It's hot.
There's no such thing as perfect people. There's no such thing as a perfect life. So come as you are, broken and scarred. Lift up your heart and be amazed and be changed by a perfect God.
Okay, so I'm always amazed because nothing ever changes, Dave. I mean, the song is telling us we have to incorporate the imperfections in order for it to be perfect. And so God just says, come, just come as you are, broken and scarred. And that's me. That's your host of Journey with Judy right here on Lake 96.1 this morning, just reminding us that God meets us where we're at, and he takes us from that point. And I think the problem that we have is we're expecting something different. We think God's like us sometimes. And thank God, God is not like me, because I'm always expecting so much. I've been called high maintenance before, Dave. I've been told I put the high in high maintenance. And, you know, I don't think I expect too much. I really don't. I think that it... All right, here's the problem. An expectation is what you think is supposed to be, whether it's a person or a situation, right? I mean, that's just a simple definition of the expectation. So would it be unreasonable, Dave, that I'm here with you for an hour on a Sunday morning and I go home, would it be unreasonable to expect that, like, that my kids who might have made breakfast would clean up after themselves? It would be nice that they might, if there was a dishwasher to be empty, that they might empty it. That if they walked out the door behind them because the air conditioning's on, they would close it. That they would close the garage door. That there was if there was a garbage can outside, they would bring it in. Like, some of these, this does not seem unreasonable to me, Dave. And the thing that they keep saying is, like, that's really not my job, Mom. That's really not my job. Well, of course, I very... probably unchristlike, remind them of all the things that I do that are not my job, Dave. You know what I'm saying? So, but here's what I know about my man. He understands my expectations. And if he doesn't, because he always says, I never got a crystal ball when we got married. Tell me what you want. Tell me what you expect. And here's what I know. He absolutely wants to meet those expectations. So the fact that I want coffee at a certain time every day, which I get from the Walworth Landing in Walworth, my man, he wakes up saying, like, what time do you want your coffee? And if he doesn't say that, I realize that he doesn't want to get it, so I just drop a subtle hint, like, so will you be driving to Walworth anytime soon? And then, of course, he wants to, you know, accommodate me. The simple expectation that you all know about if you listen to my show is that I want a letter on my birthday or any other occasion, Mother's Day, a birthday, Christmas, whatever I want. My expectation is simple. You just got to write me this thing. It would be great if you told untruths to tell me how great I was and how much you love me. But if not, just put your feelings on a piece of paper. So apparently my expectations of my family are totally 100% unreasonable, Dave. I could literally be gone all week. My kids would do nothing. They would, the whole world, how about when the phone rings and it's like someone says, I called your house and I called 10 times and nobody answered. I have three children sitting in a family room and nobody will get the phone because my expectations are too high. Is that even a fair thing?
Yeah.
Well, there's no such thing as perfect people. However, there is such thing as desiring the highest and best good for the sake of somebody else. And so I'm saying these are not expectations. Well, they what they call them are rules. They say your rules are terrible. They're not rules. They're expectations. The rules of engagement are expectations that are going to be to their benefit, Dave. Just ask me and I'll tell you. In the meantime, we got to go to break. You are journeying with Judy right here on Lake 96.1. Right, so it's always a good morning when we have another chance to come as we are in a place where God's going to lead us, where he's going to provide for us, protect us, guide us, and direct us. Because don't we need it, Dave? I so need it. I feel like I keep doing the same thing over and over again, expecting different results. And, you know, I learned that in my 12-step program. That's called insanity, babe. Insanity. And that's sometimes the way I'm living my life. But the reality is, the people that we love the most, we only want what's best for them. Just like God, he only wants what's best for us. And sometimes it seems unreasonable and not even attainable and just dumb. Like, my kids just think all of our expectations and rules are just downright stupid. Nobody does what you do. Nobody expects what you expect. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with keeping the ceiling at the ceiling and not making the ceiling the floor. And that means I'm going to be prudent. That means I'm going to see danger coming. If you listen to last week's show, that's what we talked about. We talked about being prudent. And prudent sometimes is overly cautious in the eyes or the mind of somebody else. And it's even overly protective. It almost appears like you're trying to control a situation. And let's be honest, open, and transparent. Of course I am. Of course I am. I'm oftentimes saying to God, could you just get out of the way? I totally have this. Okay, bad, my bad. You can have it back because I messed the whole thing up. But when we're prudent, we're seeing that danger's coming and we're taking shelter. And if we're dumb, that just downright dumb, we're just moving in that same direction and we're going to pay a price that we didn't want to pay, right? Our decisions are the key in preventing injury. That was last week's show. So let's keep talking a little bit about what it means to have a plan in place, but know that it can't be successful unless the expectations are clear, Dave, right? I mean, you say you do, but can you really follow through? Right? And just in case you can't, what am I here? I'm here to help you. Duh, that's what I do here. So we know that we want to provide and protect and guide and direct the people that we love. Sometimes more than they want to be provided, guided, directed, and protected, right? But this thing about expectations, it's by definition, an expectation is a strong belief that something will happen, or it's believing that someone will achieve or wants to achieve, or at least should achieve, Dave, something. That's it. It's synonymous with assumption, presumption, prediction, and supposition, okay? Bottom line is all those things are synonymous with having some hope. And there's nothing wrong. They say that you can live without anything, but you can't live without hope. So what I was sharing with Dave before the break, because just so you know, before the show starts, we have like our own show for about 20 minutes and we talk about everything. And then we hope that it's, you know, we don't run over 7:30 and have you listening to us talking. But the thing about these expectations and what we have is that it's like a negative connotation when you talk about an expectation. I read one quote. It said, expectation feeds frustration. It's an unhealthy attachment to a person, a thing, or an outcome you only wish you could control. Another thing says, an expectation is the crime, but disappointment is the punishment. Okay. Well, I disagree with all of that, because the reality is that there's truth in some of those statements. But the truth be told, if we don't have expectations that are given to us and given by us in any relationship, how could we possibly succeed? We can't, Dave. Do you agree with me? The greatest danger for most of us. Okay, so the greatest danger for most of us is not that we aim too high, but we aim too low and get it. I've done that my whole life. And I definitely don't want the people that I love most to be doing what I'm doing. Aiming high and not getting it is nothing compared to aiming low and getting it. See, I want to be prudent. I want to be overly cautious. I so want to be overprotective, because we talked about this last week too. Not knowing is not the same as not remembering. We are in the situations we are in life because of the decisions that we made at some point in time. And see, it's not hard to make decisions when you know what your values are. When you draw your line in the sand, you put your stake in the ground, you plan, you prepare, you allow God to provide and protect, to guide and direct you. Expectations aren't bad. Rules aren't bad. They're for our protection, Dave. Like, there's certain things that we're asked to do in life because they might seem dumb, but they're going to be to our benefit. I've been super excited the last week or two following a guy named Charlie Strong. He is the head coach of the Texas Longhorns, and I don't care if you like college football or you hate football. The fact of the matter is this guy is putting that stake in the ground. This guy is making it perfectly clear what is expected of someone who's going to play for his team. And he's got these five simple rules. And apparently some of the guys just can't, or let me rephrase that, won't do what's expected of them. Here's what I love about the guy. He made it perfectly clear what's expected. Dave, tell me that you knew when you said I do what you were getting into. No, no, no. Tell me when that little baby came out of Angela, you didn't know. We try to step into relationship with people believing that we got a crystal ball, believing we're going to know what they need, when they need it, how they need it, and why they need it. But the reality is we don't, and we got to pray for people to come alongside of us that are going to allow us, encourage us, and empower us to raise the bar. To raise the bar because we're capable of so much more than what we actually think, say, and do. But when we surround ourselves with people or we allow a culture to let us lower the bar, like I've seen in college football, this guy is crazy. And just so you know, we are going to get to Kennedy's dating rules really soon in the next segment probably. So stay tuned if you're only listening for Kennedy's dating rules, like my father-in-law is. Gotta love that guy. He listens to every show. I love him every Sunday morning. But anyway, so this guy, Charlie Strong, has made it really clear. He's not only saying it. Because you're not what you say, you are what you do. And he is following through. He is making hard decisions. And Dave, I know this will come as a surprise to you, but I've called his office 10 times in the last 10 days. And I know they think I'm some crazy lunatic from Fontana, Wisconsin, but I'm calling this guy to say, you are making men. You are as strong as your name. His name is Charlie Strong. And he is doing hard things. And his rules are so, Dave, to me, they're like a no-brainer. But see, what we give so much credit to seems so out of the ordinary, when the reality is these are simple things that you could expect of somebody who's getting to be representing you on those levels, right? I mean, that's a really big deal. And of course, I kept thinking about us as Christians, as people of faith. The bare minimum is expected of us. All we are asked to do is love. Dave, how hard is it to love? It is so hard to love. Of course, I love you when you're saying and doing and being everything I want you to say, be, and do. And there's such a fine line between love and hate. But if you're loving somebody, then you are desiring the highest and best good for the sake of that person. And this guy's getting paid millions of dollars to not put football players on the field. But to put men out there, to put men that are going to be godly men, that are going to be honest. That's his number one rule. Be honest. Treat women with respect. All I had to hear was those two before I'm flying to Texas and thanking the man and wanting every one of my children and my daughters to go there. I actually left a message and said, I want my kids to play with your kids because you obviously are raising them the same way. Okay, we got to go to break, but we are so excited to talk about what it is to have expectations, why that's a good thing, and especially when my kid, who's going to be allowed to date, just a month or so from now, we got to put those expectations in writing, in stone, like the Ten Commandments on a tablet so I can bang her over the head with it. We'll be back after the break. And Marty Vanderstappen, I know you're listening, and you too had the dating rule when you were 16 for your kids, and I love that. You are journeying with Judy right here on Lake 96.1. Thanks to Greg Kunis at Kunis Country Auto Group. I do want to live like that. The sidewalk prophets are saying, I want to live like that. I want to be strong in the Lord. I want to never give up hope because I'm going to do great things. And so are you. When you stand up and step up, that you stand for something and fall for nothing, that you become all God has created you to be. Because if you make decisions now, remember that quote, Dave, from one of the first couple shows, your present will be in your past. But your past will always be present in your future. Like, that's why I'm a goofy mother. That's why I'm a terrible wife, because of the decisions that I made. And those are not excuses. That's just reality. So we have a lot of expectations at our home. A very good psychologist friend of mine, who I wish could just live in my house, he told me, forget the word rules. It just has such a negative connotation. Kids hate rules. Teenagers hate rules. I think I hate rules. He said, use the word expectation. It sounds so much better. It's so much more digestible, and it's actually more empowering and makes someone feel less controlled. I would agree with that. So, of course, my kids' response to the rules were, well, if they're only expectations and not rules, then you can't serve up the consequence when we break them. They're a little quick on their feet. I think all of them should be attorneys. But anyway, an expectation is simply a strong belief that something is going to happen. Or an expectation is that someone will achieve or should achieve something. Well, when it comes to my daughters, it was hard to keep that rule for my boys. I kept it, though. Actually, I allowed Carter to date 6 months before his 16th birthday, and it was as if I'd let Satan rule our home. It was a very bad decision. I will not make that same mistake twice. Because, Dave, then it's worth making. If you make a mistake and you learn from it, then to learn it. Yeah, so unfortunately for my two daughters, their lives are going to be really miserable compared to their brothers. And if I could put them in a cage and not let them leave my home, I would. And it has nothing to do with not trusting them. Nothing to do with not trusting them. I want to set them up to succeed. I want them to live in a manner worthy of the call that they've received. See, because people don't recover from what I've been through, and I don't want my daughters to ever walk their journey of faith not knowing who they are and whose they are. And in one instant, that could totally change, and they could become damaged goods in their mind, Dave, not in ever in God's mind. And then they live differently out of that paradigm. So that's why we have just a couple dating rules, expectations, because here's the deal. Here's the number one thing. Kennedy's going to be 16, which, Dave, in all of my research, it clearly reiterated that 16 is the perfect time to start anything serious in terms of a relationship. You're more mature. You're more able. It's just a good time. So I was affirmed by that. Turning 16 is a good time to start talking about these things, put them in stone, bang them over the head, and then, most importantly, don't just talk about it, but follow through on it. So on September 25th, Kennedy is going to get a smartphone. And she's going to start dating. So here's a couple of the things that have to happen before that date. When she's attracted to a young man, she needs to mark her calendar, Dave. For 40 days, it's our 40-day rule. For 40 days before you go on a date with anybody, you will observe, you will watch, you will see that person from a distance. Because when you're so close to something, Dave, you only see what, you know, you put on your rose-colored glasses, and then somebody gets out of your peripheral vision, and you can't really see them for what they are because you're only wanting to see the good. They call that the romance stage of a marriage. Dave, how long has it been since you've been there? It's hard. It's hard to stay there when you see someone, you know, in the different light that you end up seeing them in. So 40 days is what she has to observe somebody with their parents, with their classmates, with other people. And by then, I'm hoping and praying that they fall by the wayside, because after day four, they're not as good as you thought they were. So that's rule number one. Rule number two is, after you make the 40-day mark, now you need to give me a list of every letter of the alphabet, 26 attributes of this person. I want to know what it is that attracts you to them. Because initially, it's an attraction. I'm attracted to you for this reason. So A through Z, I need to know why you're drawn to that person. While you're counting your 40 days and making your A to Z list, I will be reviewing their social media. I will be seeing who it is. Yeah, absolutely. It's part of a rule. I mean, I already... It's my expectation. Thank you, Dave. My expectation, which is a strong belief that something will happen or that someone will achieve or should achieve something. And I want my daughter to be happy. I want her to be healthy. And I want her to be a whole person. And any decision that she could make could be a deal changer for her. So while I'm reviewing their social media, I will be determining the type of person that they are. When I say I mean we, and we is Bob and I. Their dates will only be, after this time, in public places. They will meet at our home and never at somebody else's home. When I say never, that's at least for the first year. I'm not saying Kennedy can never go to a boy's house. I'm just saying that until I am very secure that she will be provided, protected, guided, and directed in a godly way, she will not be going to some boy's house after school between 3 and 6 when their parents aren't home. Do you get that, Dave? Do you get why that wouldn't be beneficial to my daughter? Any daughter, thank you. The other thing that would be really helpful initially in this dating expectation is we date in groups, Dave. Because I got to tell you, if you and me, if I was out with 6 people, things might go a little bit differently than if it was just the 2 of us in my basement and there's no parents home. And you know what I'm saying? I know that from experience, okay? Many a girl whoever encountered my son Carter would know that I needed to learn from that situation. Anyway. When you're in groups, Dave, it would obviously lead to the next rule about it avoids temptation. See, we need to put our daughter, all of our kids, in a situation where they will succeed. We have to avoid situations that would increase temptation. So when my daughter said, you know, we're going to go to a movie, that's a public place. I'm okay with that. But if you're going to see, what's a really bad movie, Dave? I don't know. Some movie that's sexually explicit, I would vote no. I would vote for something really funny or really action-packed. You know what I'm saying? Is that a dumb thing? No. The other thing I made Kennedy do the other day was delete every explicit song on her iPod. If you listen to the songs our kids are listening to, you would drive off the road into a telephone pole on purpose because you wouldn't believe what they're singing. That was the, if she wants to start dating, she's not, what you put in your brain, what you listen to, Dave, what you think about, your thoughts become your actions. And so that was one of the things, like we're a month away from this dating thing, so you need to delete all of that type of music, which the good news is she willingly did. We're almost done with the rules, friends. She's going to be needing to dress modestly. That would be really important, Dave. Do you agree? Because sometimes girls come over to my house and I think, number one, where are your clothes? Number two, where is your mother? And how could your father let you out of the house this way? Okay? So we got to be dressing modestly. And how about this? Let's date people our own age. There's really no benefit to my 16-year-old daughter to be dating an 18 or a 19-year-old boy. People used to say that about my son, Carter. He's really nice. No, he's not nice. He's an 18-year-old boy who thinks with other parts of his body. He's a nice boy, but you cannot put him in a situation with your daughter that would not be beneficial to your daughter. True that? True that. Finally, babe, Dave, I always say babe. I don't mean to say Dave. You know what I mean? Dave, we got to have an escape plan. Now, when I mentioned this to Kennedy, she thought that was the stupidest thing ever. Let's be aware that we don't even have a fire escape plan in our house. We're just going to jump out the window. I'm not worried about the fire in my house. I'm worried about the fire in a relationship, a situation where my daughter feels that she is being taken advantage of, pressured, out of control, uncomfortable, awkward, you name the word. I need an escape plan in place with her. My kids all have had an escape plan since they could talk and walk and go on a play date. They say one word over the phone, and I know that's my cue to go there. I don't have to ask why. I can't tell you the word because then you'll know if they're hanging out with you that they're saying it. So it's a secret word that all my kids know, and it's a different for all of them, that if I say, how's it going, they tell me that word, and I go get them. We go get them. So far, do you like my rules? Dave is doing this whole thing where he's like, shut your pie hole. Time is running out. You got to go. But here's the thing. Kennedy's response initially was, you don't trust me. If you have all these rules, then that means you don't trust me. It is so the opposite. I probably have more faith in my daughter's moral compass than I did in both of my boys put together and any other 16-year-old girl. And part of that is because I have her locked in a cage so none of you can get to her. But the reality is it's not about trust. It's about being prudent. It's about being prudent, seeing danger coming and taking shelter. Because you say you do, but you can't follow through. And so I said, just in case you can't, I'll help you. Lack of preparation would be the reason that things would not fall into place properly when it came to my daughter and dating. Because, see, the greatest danger is not that we aim too high and don't reach that, but that we aim too low and do. So I am going to assume, presume, predict, and hope that when it comes to dating, the expectations that we set forth are just simply a way that my daughter will achieve what I know that she's capable of. You are journeying with Judy right here on Lake 96.1, and we'll be back to wrap it up. Unfortunately, this is a very short show today, Dave. I am sweating, though, but it's a very short show. Goodbye. Okay, so whether we have great expectations or you want to call them rules of engagement, they're there for our benefit. They're there to provide and protect, to guide and direct. And all we want is to live in a manner worthy of the call that we received. And that requires planning. It requires being prudent. It requires seeing danger and taking shelter, not only for ourselves, but the ones that we love. So this week, let's set the bar so high that we'll never, ever, ever achieve it. Because that is the goal of the Christian life. You have journeyed with Judy once again this Sunday morning, right here on Lake 96.1. So this week, you got to do what, Dave? Keep it hot, honest, open, and transparent. Peace out.